back to Classmates Spell Bee Season 10, presented by Classmate and powered by the Times of India. This is an initiative by Radio Mirchi. And now let's put the record straight on the word gad. Dating back to late Middle English, the word gad derives from gadling, which means wanderer or vagabond. Gad is defined as to go from place to place in pursuit of pleasure. And now it's time for us to look at the scoreboard at the end of round one. Currently, we have in third position with 15 points, Garv Jain. Tied in second position with 20 points apiece, Shikha and Yashart. And our current leader with 30 points is Harsh. That means, Garv, I'm afraid it's the end of the road for you. It was a tough first round, and I know that there's some words also that you were unfamiliar with. But you've really persevered in coming back, and that is testament to your dedication, to your hard work. And it's a source of inspiration, I think, for a lot of children who are watching this competition. Thank you for being with us. Let's give him a big round of applause. It's time now for us to continue the competition with our three contestants, which means we go on to round two. You know the rules, but let me remind you. In round two, I will ask each of you to spell four words, each worth 10 points. You can ask me for clues. Those clues include the definition of the word, part of speech, usage in a sentence, and language of origin. However, if at the end of round two there's a tie, then the same sequence of criteria will be used to eliminate a contestant that was used in round one. We begin round two. Let's call to the podium Yashart from Masukbhai Kothari High School in Pune. How was round one for you?
It was down to the wire on the last one.
It was difficult and it was close with you and Shikha. Now you're both tied at 20-20. Round two, the words tend to get a little bit more difficult. You have used your Classmate Connect option, which means that you can only rely on your own spell check and all the hard work that you've done. Good luck. Four words to spell. Your first word is worth 10 points, and that word is Mistral. Mistral or Mistral?
What's the language of origin?
Latin via Provençal, via French.
What does it mean?
A strong, cold, northwesterly wind that blows through southern France into the Mediterranean in the winter.
Could you use it in a sentence?
They bundle themselves in thick coats to protect themselves from the onslaught of the Mistral.
I would go as M-I-S-T-R-A-L.
Is that a guess?
Kind of.
An educated guess. You're right! Your next word in round two, also worth 10 points, is pika or pika.
What does it mean?
It means a small mammal related to the rabbits found in Asia.
Could you use it in a sentence?
In the mountains of Eurasia, a pika often shares its burrow with a snowfinch.
I would like to go with P-I-C-A.
That's incorrect. The accurate spelling is P-I-K-A. So I'm afraid we can't give you points for that. You do still have two words remaining in round two. Your third word is worth 10 points. That word is commonweal.
What does it mean?
It means the welfare of the public.
What is its origin?
Middle English.
Could you use it in a sentence?
The Prime Minister had to take drastic austerity measures for the commonweal.
So it's C-O-M-M-O-N-W-E-A-L.
That is absolutely spot on. Very well done. You still have one word remaining in round two. And if you spell this word correctly, you will have a solid score of 50 points. Your word to spell is mosaiced.
Mosaiced. What does it mean?
Decorated with a mosaic.
What is its origin?
Latin via French via Middle English.
Use it in a sentence.
The mosaiced floor of the house was her daughter's idea.
I'd like to go with M-O-S-A-I-C-K-E-D.
That is absolutely correct. Yashart, at the end of round two, I'm pleased to say that you have a very solid score of 50 points. Please have a seat. Let's welcome now back to the podium our only female contestant. Put your hands together for Shikha from Witty International School in Mumbai. So the competition is heating up.
Yes, it is.
All three of you are tough competition for each other. What did you make of the words in round two for Yashart?
I knew half of them and half of them were like completely unknown.
I hope you know the four that I'm going to say now.
Right.
Good luck to you. You're currently on 20 points and your Classmate Connect option is still available to you. Your word to spell for 10 points is strafe.
Strafe.
That is correct.
Can you give me the definition?
attack repeatedly with bombs or machine gun fire from low-flying aircraft.
Can you use it in a sentence?
After losing half his men, the general's last recourse was to strafe the enemy soldiers until they retreated.
What language of origin is this?
It is actually a humorous adaptation from German.
S-T-R-A-F-E, strafe.
That is correct. Well done. Your next word, also worth 10 points, is pieing.
Pieing.
That is correct.
What part of speech is this?
It is a verb.
Can you give me the definition?
The act of putting potatoes or other root crops into a pit and covering them with straw or earth.
And can you use it in a sentence?
Pieing potatoes was our favorite activity at summer camp.
I would like to use my classmate connect option.
Shikha would like to use her classmate connect option.
Pieing, as in a verb?
As in a verb.
Okay, so we want to give you P-I-E-I-N-G.
The choice is yours.
I like to go with them.
You'd like to go with them? They're right. Well done, classmates. You've helped Shikha take her total to 40 points. You're doing very well. You still have two words remaining. If you spell this word correctly, you'll be tied with Yashat. Your word to spell is phantasmagoria.
Can I have the definition?
A sequence of real or imaginary images, like what is seen in a dream.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Once the anesthetic kicked in, she was lost in a phantasmagoria of faces and voices.
What language of origin is this?
Greek via French.
P-H-A-N-T-A-S-M-A-G-O-R-I-A. Phantasmagoria.
Very well done. It's a long word to spell and you didn't falter, so congratulations. You're currently tied with Yashat, but you could take the lead if you spell this word correctly. Your word to spell is toucan.
Can you give me the definition?
A fruit-eating bird with a massive bill and bright plumage.
Can you use it in a sentence?
When a toucan fences with its bill, it does so to establish its dominance.
Toucan. T-O-U-C-A-N. Toucan.
That is absolutely correct. At the end of round two, you have an incredible score of 60 points. Well played. It's time now to welcome our third contestant of the day. Put your hands together for Harshvardhan from DPS Bangalore. The words do get more tough. You did very well in round one. You had 30 points. Yashart and Shikha have now gone ahead because there are many points to be scored in round two. 40 points. So they've taken their totals up to 60 and 50 respectively. Only two of you will make it through to round three. With your eye on the prize, I wish you all the best. Your first word in round two, worth 10 points, is chassis. Chassis, also pronounced chassis.
Okay, what's the definition?
The base frame of a car, carriage, or other wheeled vehicle.
Can you use in a sentence for me?
The strength of the chassis of a car determines how safe it is in the event of an accident.
Okay, so I would like to spell it as C-H-A-S-S-I, chassis.
Absolutely right, well done. If you spell this word correctly, you will be tied with Yashat. Your word to spell is apostat.
Apostat.
That is correct.
What's the definition?
The region of the hypothalamus of the brain which is believed to control a person's appetite for food.
Please in a sentence for me.
When I see the amount of food on Sanjay's plate, I wonder whether or not he has an apostat.
What's the language of origin?
1950s portmanteau word.
I would like to spell it as A-P-I-S-T-A-T, apostat.
I'm afraid that's incorrect. The accurate spelling of apostat is A-P-P-E-S-T-A-T. It actually derives from appetite and thermostat, which means we cannot give you points for that. But no matter, you still have two words remaining in round two. Your third word to spell, worth 10 points, is broom.
What's the definition?
Mist or fog.
Could you use a sentence for me?
All the flights were delayed because of the dense broom over the city.
Okay, what's the language of origin?
Latin via French.
I'd go with B-R-U-M-E, broom.
You're right. You're currently tied with Yashat, but if you spell this word correctly, you will take your total to 60 points and ensure your place in the third round. Your word to spell is legatee.
Okay, what's the definition?
A person who receives a legacy.
Okay, can you use it in a sentence for me?
As a legatee, you have a responsibility towards making sure the rest of your family is provided for.
What's the language of origin?
Latin.
What's the part of speech?
It is a noun.
So the spelling I would like to go with is L-E-G-I-T-E-E.
I thought you had it, but that's incorrect. I'm afraid it's not an I, it's an A, as in legacy, legatee. So L-E-G-A-T-E-E is the accurate spelling, which means we cannot give you points for that. But at the end of round two, Harsh, you still have a very solid score of 50 points. Please have a seat. With that zesty performance, we've reached the end of round two. And before we lunge ahead into round three, chew over this yet another three-letter word, SEP. And we'll talk about it, but after a short break. This is Classmate Spell Bee Season 10, presented by Classmate and powered by The Times of India.